Hello, my dear butterflies. Welcome to Hidaya online class. I am Prasida, your social science teacher. So, let's start our social science class. Okay. Have you studied previous topics? Yes, really good. In previous class, we studied about oceans. What are oceans? Yes, oceans are vast water bodies. Oceans are vast water bodies. Which are the major oceans on the earth? Correct. Pacific Ocean, Atlantic Ocean, Indian Ocean, Antarctic and Arctic Oceans are the five major oceans on the earth. In previous class, we studied about the Pacific Ocean. Today, we will learn about Atlantic, Indian, Antarctic and Arctic Oceans. Okay? First, we discuss Atlantic Ocean. The Atlantic Ocean is the second largest ocean. The Grand Banks, which is an important fishing ground, is in this ocean. Okay, the Grand Banks, which is an important fishing ground, is in this ocean. The northern part of this ocean is the world's busiest ocean road. Okay, the northern part of this ocean is the world busiest ocean road. Okay, all of you clear? Okay. Next one, the Indian Ocean. It stands third in size. It has a distinction of being an ocean named after a country. The Arabian Sea and the Bay of Bengal are part of the Indian Ocean. Asia is situated the north of Indian Ocean. The coral reefs are an important feature of the Indian Ocean. What are called coral reefs? Okay. Corals are formed by the accumulation of calcium compounds secreted by tiny marine organisms are called coral polypus found in tropical oceans. Okay, listen. The coral reefs are an important feature of the Indian Ocean. What are called coral reefs? Corals are formed by the accumulation of calcium compounds secreted by tiny marine organism called coral reefs. Okay, coral polypus found in tropical oceans. അതായത് പവിഴപ്പുറ്റുകള് ഇന്ത്യൻ മഹാസമുദ്രത്തിലെ ഒരു പ്രധാന പ്രത്യേകതയാണ്. ഉഷ്ണമേഖലാ സമുദ്രങ്ങളിൽ കാണപ്പെടുന്ന കോറൽ പോളിപ്പുകൾ എന്ന സമുദ്രജീവികളുടെ മൃതാവശിഷ്ടങ്ങൾ അടിഞ്ഞു കൂടിയാണ് എന്ത് കോറൽ റീഫ്സ് പവിഴപ്പുറ്റുകള് രൂപപ്പെടുന്നത്. ഓക്കെ, ക്ലിയർ? ലക്ഷദ്വീപ് ഐലാൻഡ് ആർ ഫോമഡ് ഓഫ് ദീസ് അക്യുമുലേറ്റഡ് കോറൽ പോളിപ്പസ്. ഓക്കെ, ഓൾ ഓഫ് യു ക്ലിയർ? Okay, next we move to the fourth ocean, Antarctic Ocean. Okay, next one, Antarctic Ocean. The ocean bordering Antarctica is known as the Antarctic Ocean. It is also known as Southern Ocean. Because it is located in Southern Pole. Since the region experiences severe cold, the surface of this ocean is almost entirely frozen. It is believed that the ocean bed is rich in minerals. Many varieties of fish are also present in this ocean. Okay, once again I repeat it. Antarctic Ocean, bordering Antarctica is known as the Antarctic Ocean. It is also known as Southern Ocean because it is located in Southern Pole. Since the region experiences severe cold, the surface of this ocean is almost entirely frozen. It is believed that the ocean bed is rich in minerals. Many varieties of fish are also present in this ocean. Okay, all of you clear? Okay. Next one. Next we see the fifth ocean. Arctic Ocean. Okay, Arctic Ocean is the smallest and coldest of all the oceans. It is situated in the North Pole. It remains frozen for over 6 Months a year, shallow water, low salinity, frozen surface are the major features of the Arctic Ocean. Okay, all of you clear? Arctic Ocean is the smallest and coldest of all the oceans. It is situated in the North Pole. It remains frozen for over 6 months a year. Shallow water, low salinity, frozen surface are the major features of Arctic Ocean. All of you understand? Okay.
About 70% of the surface of the earth is ocean water. And it's divided up in 5 parts from biggest to smallest. Pacific, Atlantic, Indian, Southern, Arctic. Pacific, Atlantic, Indian, Southern, Arctic.
I'm the Pacific, to be specific. I'm a third of the Earth's surface where my turf is. And my Mariana Trench is the very, very deepest in the sea.
And I'm the Atlantic, named after the Greek god Atlas, with the Bermuda Triangle and the Gulf Stream in me.
I'm the Indian Ocean, I'm the warmest around.
And I'm the Southern Ocean, where Antarctica is found.
And I'm the Arctic, the smallest and the shallowest. But that's fine, you see, I've got more ice than you've ever seen. Even polar bears walk on me.
We're the Pacific, Atlantic, Indian, Southern, Arctic. Pacific, Atlantic, Indian, Southern, Arctic.
One more time.
Pacific, Atlantic, Indian, Southern, Arctic. Pacific, Atlantic, Indian, Southern, Arctic.
You would have now realized that the earth we live in is vast and diverse. The plant and animal life, including man, make use of this diversity for their existence. Man depend on the earth land masses for the basic need like water, shelter and clothing. Okay, water, food, shelter and clothing. Like the continents and the oceans also play an important role in making life on earth possible. We utilize oceans directly or indirectly for various purposes such as fishing, minerals, exploration, transport and recreation. Okay, what are the purposes of ocean? What are the uses of ocean? Okay, first one, fishing. Malse sambathu. And the next one, minerals. Edana dadu nikshepam. Exploration, padyaveshanangale. Transportation and recreation. Gadagadam. We know that in a kind of namle endeyunnunde. Oceans use cheyunnundile. Okay. This beautiful earth belongs to all living beings. It is a duty of every individual to preserve the resources on land and in water for the future generation. Okay, all of you clear? Okay, that's all today. In this chapter is over. In this chapter, we studied about continents and ocean. All of you understood all topics. Thank you. Have a nice day.